Try. Look. Whatever this thing is, whether it's home or school or in general, we'll talk about it after school. Now please go to school.
Okay, Mum.
Give me a hug.
Oh, do I have to?
Yes, you do. That's my girl. Now have a good day at school.
Why are you wearing my jacket?
What?
Why are you wearing my jacket?
Because I like it.
Yeah, and it's still my jacket.
Yeah, but it looks better on me. It
doesn't actually.
Well, thanks for the confidence boost.
Oh, would you come here?
What?
What is wrong with you?
Nothing.
What is wrong with you?
I literally just said
And I'm not an idiot. What is wrong with you?
Well, you kind of are an idiot because you're leaving me to go to college.
I have to go.
No, you don't. Just get a job in McDonald's.
And you know that's not what I want to do.
Dad did the artwork thing again.
He's such an idiot.
I don't get it. He didn't react this way when you said you wanted to.
Yeah, but I gave up, didn't I? And I'm happy I did, because it turns out that actually you're a million times better than I was anyway.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
You'll never be good enough.
Mum always thought you were good enough.
And look where Mum is. She's drugged up, she's crazy, and she's in rehab. Her point is invalid.
Mum's neither drugged up or crazy, and you know that. The fact that she's ill doesn't make her point any less valid. She knew exactly what she was talking about.
Dad ripped up another one.
Which one?
Portrait.
Look, I'm not in until later, but I'll go and talk to your teacher again if you need me to.
Okay. Well, that was a cheery chat.
I'm going to see Mum later.
Why?
Because she's still our mum.
Right.
Do you have anything you want
to
say?
I have nothing to say to her.
Okay.
Well, I'm gonna go.
Why are you going into school so early?
No reason.
You're totally seeing your boyfriend.
No, I'm not.
You're totally seeing your boyfriend.
Whatever.
Oh, you can wear my jumper, by the way.
Thanks, I'll cherish it forever.
I'll see you later.
Too much.
Imogen. Imogen. Imogen!
Sean, I'm on the phone.
Well, Mum told me to come and get you.
Breakfast is ready.
Tracy, you've got to go.
Sean, why are you holding your stomach?
I don't feel very well.
Sean, are you pregnant?
No, no.
What have you got in there, Sean?
Sean, tell me.
Listen,
I was going to give it to you.
Mm-hmm. But you just seemed busy and asleep when you were speaking to Tracy. And I didn't find the right time.
Right time for what?
It only came this morning, okay?
Sean. Sean, are they my results?
I promise I was going to give them to you.
What's the matter?
I'm never going to see you again.
Don't be silly. I'm only going down the road. I can come see you every day.
Okay. Well, you'd better open your results then. Can I stay?
Sure. Sean,
have you opened them?
Not yet. Stop humming.
Well, open them then.
Okay.
Well, have you opened them?
Yeah.
Wow.
I got in, Sean.
Oh. Take no notice of me. I'm just being silly. But you've got to promise me. You got a pinky promise me that you'll come and see me when you're free.
Of course I will.
And that you'll take me to school today.
What? No!
Yes, you pinky promised.
Fine.
I'm sorry. I'm so late,
I
know.
I really need to talk to you.
About an hour.
Okay, I'm so sorry.
We don't have time for this. We've got to go.
We don't have time for this.
I need to tell you something.
We've got to go.
Why won't you listen to me?
I didn't know this was going to happen.
Hi, class, I know I'm so late, I'm sorry.
We're going to be continuing with Shakespeare.
Can anybody tell me the date?
April 20th, 1999.
Get down. Everybody. Get down.
Mum. I really needed to talk to you.
Some were shrouded in blossoms. Others wore their blooms like brooches and medallions.
Even those who turned their backs or refused point blank to accept such honours
were decorated with buds,
unseasonable fruits and rosettes the same as others. They had also planned further surprises for those who had swept under the aftermath.
Garlands and bouquets were planted in lockers and cupboards. Time to erupt!
Panicky? No, I'm...
why, because I'm not on the good books of teachers and all that, but I love you so much, and I'll hopefully see you later. Bye.
Mum? Yeah, it's just me. I know it's quite an odd time to call you as it's the middle of the day and I'm at school, but I just wanted to hear your voice, really. How did the job interview go? Good. I knew you'd smash it. No, I've just got to stay quiet because I'm in the library, you see, and I don't want to distract anyone. No, I'm fine, honestly. I'm fine. Mum, I just wondered if tonight we could have one of our girly nights and have a pamper session or something, just like we used to. Because I've really missed you so much recently, I just can't wait to see you tonight, okay? I love you more.
Mum? Mum? Something bad's happened. I can't explain. Two boys. They have guns. All I can see is people running. I'm safe right now. I'm in the library. I'm on the floor.
Hi, it's me. Look, I take it you're still at work because obviously you're not answering, but it's fine, I'll leave you a voicemail anyway. How are you? So stupid, you can't even reply. Thank you, Mum, for everything. You're amazing, you know. You really are. Right, I've got to go because I'm a little bit behind on work, but. It's fine. So I'll be home a little bit late, but see you later.
Mum? Yeah, Mum, it's me. I know this is a bad time, but I just wanted you to know that fight we had earlier, you know I didn't mean those things I said, don't you? I know. Go on my laptop. I don't need to tell you the password, because you already know. And you know how we always talk about my music career, and how I wanted to go to university. Well, like I said, go on my laptop, go to my music tracks, and go to track 21. I want you to listen to that track. Just promise me you'll listen to it, please! I love you.
Hi, Mum. I'm just ringing because it's your birthday. I just want to hear your voice. Are we still going out for dinner tonight? Good, because we can't wait. Is the whole family coming? Good. Mum, I just want you to know that I'm really grateful for everything you do for me. And I love you so much.
Finally, overcome by their own magnificence or hay fever, with the flower boys pinned, the last bloom on their cells. Somewhat selfishly, perhaps. Experts are now wondering how two apparently quiet kids from an apple pie town
could get their hands on a veritable rainforest. Of plants and flowers, where such fascinations began. What should lead this outpouring of nature?
What they reckon is this.
Deny a man the right to carry flowers of his own,
and he's liable to wind up on the business end of a flower someone else has grown. As for the two boys, it's the same old debate. Is it something in the mind that grows from birth like a seed?
Or is it society that makes a person that kind?